Go back with us for a moment to the 40s and 50s. And do you remember the mambo? It was the dance to dance in those years, so the music stopped and the mambo became yesterday. But a new movie is out, The Mambo Kings, and this is, therefore, a time of mambo madness. Art McFarlane.
It was Mambo Night at the Manhattan Club called SOBs, a new attraction at the club where an instructor gives lessons on the mambo and then the customers dance all they want.
I like the rhythm and the beat. I like the way that you can move to it.
SOBs already had a reputation as a place to go for Latin music, but Mambo Night promises to be very good for business.
This is our second night, and we've had packed dance classes both nights. People have stayed on the dance floor the entire time of the dance class, and then they practice later on to the band.
The new movie called Mambo Kings has a lot to do with what could turn out to be a mambo craze. The film follows the lives of Cuban-born musicians who helped bring the dance to this country some 40 years ago.
Mambo was one of the most popular dances back in the 50s, and known as the king of the dances, as a matter of fact.
At this Arthur Murray Dance School in Yonkers, there has been a big increase in people wanting to learn how to mambo, and the dance seems easy enough to learn.
It's a very sensuous dance. It has that Latin beat that makes you move your hips, similar to the cha-cha. That's about it to me. I like to be able to move.
And the mambo has added new excitement to dancing, which for some people is a great way to relax.
People are dancing an awful lot, especially with all the crazy things going on in the world, so people have to have a little fun to come dancing.
In fact, it's so much fun, the dance is likely to be around for long after the movie is gone and forgotten. Ian Yonkers, Art McFarlane, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
But I don't know.